At the age of 17, Michael J. Fox left his home in Vancouver and moved to Los Angeles, California. Here, he hoped to expand his acting career by being able to audition for larger, more serious roles, as well as gain recognition. At first, he got a recurring role on the television series Homicide USA, but it was canceled before he had a chance to make a large enough impact. Soon, he found it more and more difficult to gain roles until eventually they came to a stop. He now found himself without work, alone, contemplating moving back to Canada. However, he knew if he was to return to his family and friends, he would be giving up on his dream, so he decided to stick with it. Over the next several months, he began to struggle and started selling off his possessions and other valuables just to be able to afford a meal. Then he got a call back for a new television series called Family Ties. He used to play the character of Alex B. Keaton, and the show would revolve around his on-screen parents.
By the time you got to Family Ties, you were really on skid row.
Yeah, I was both broke, and when I was negotiating a deal for it, my phone service was cut off, so I was using a payphone at a chicken, fast food chicken place in my neighborhood, and I was passing it off as my phone. It was like my office. And so I was on the phone negotiating this contract for like hundreds of thousands of dollars.
After the pilot aired, people took to his sense of humor and loved him. The producers gathered and decided to rewrite the show to be centered around Michael. Within a year, Michael was on the cover of magazines and became a household name for anybody who was a fan of television. The sunburst of success came as a shock to many because he had started so strong on Family Ties, but was virtually an unknown before. His previous work included minor roles except for Leo Me, which he starred in when he was 15 years old back in Canada. But the show would not air in the US until two seasons into Family Ties. By then, Michael was a star. He soon broke out into the film world, starring in the teen comedy Teen Wolf, as well as continuing to work on Family Ties. Then, in 1985, Steven Spielberg and Robert Zemeckis contacted Family Ties producer and writer Gary Goldberg. They explained that they wanted Michael to play the lead role of Marty McFly in their new film, Back to the Future. But he declined on Michael's behalf before even asking him. If he left the show, the ratings would drop because at the time, his on-screen mother, Meredith Baxter, was also away having her first child. So Spielberg and Zemeckis went and found another actor to replace him.
We shot for 5 weeks with Eric. He was totally professional, but there was just something missing.
He's a magnificent actor, but his comedy sensibilities were very different than what I had written with Bob, and he and I just never were able to make that work.
And he showed me the first 5 weeks of footage cut together, and he just said, I don't think we're getting the laughs that I was hoping we would get. And I looked at Bob, and I realized that he was absolutely correct, and I said, Bob, what do you want to do?
So I had to make this horrific decision, which was very heartbreaking for everybody. But luckily, I was able to convince the studio to let me reshoot 5 weeks of work.
Months later, they came back explaining that the actor was not working and they wanted to reshoot the entire film, and they were adamant about Michael starring in it. The three of them gathered and came to the conclusion that Michael would work on Family Ties throughout the day and film Back to the Future at night. He continued this routine for several months until the movie premiered. At this point, his career was solidified. Family Ties gave him a start, but Back to the Future showed that he was a Hollywood star.
We'll be right back. Here is Michael J. Fox. Right?
You love him, Michael J. Fox.
Please say hello to Michael J. Fox.
After several years to follow, he continued making movies, including two sequels and several other films, while continuing to work on Family Ties until the show ended. But there was a threat about to face him that would change his life and career. While filming Doc Hollywood, he discovered his first signs of Parkinson's disease.
I was doing a film in Florida and was partying pretty good and was used to waking up in not in great shape, but I woke up one morning and my pinky was twitching, and it was just persistent. And I realized that it just there's nothing I could do to stop it. And I thought, is this like DTs? Who gets DTs in a pinky? You know, with a lot of injury, a lot of catastrophic illness, it's like stepping off a curb and getting hit by a bus. But with Parkinson's, it's like actually being stuck in the middle of the road while the bus is coming. And you can hear it. You have no idea how big it is. You have no idea how fast it's going. You have no idea whether it's going to hit you all the way or just going to graze you and screw you up. It's a lot to think about. And it's not anything that I was ready to introduce to the neighbors until I really understood it.
When he first contacted his doctor explaining his symptoms, he could not believe that he was being told he had Parkinson's. He was just starting his career off and was too young to have it. So he left and denied it.
And then I went to the neurologist, and he diagnosed me, and I was 29 years old. I didn't see it coming.
You were in denial, weren't you?
I thought it was BS. There's no way I could have Parkinson's.
You said, like with everything else, you were looking for an angle. You were looking for a way out.
Yeah, I thought it was negotiable. Call my agent. Can you get me out of this?
After the disease worsened and progressed, he went back to his doctor, and they both came to the conclusion that he did in fact have Parkinson's. At that point, he took to drinking heavily.
I struggled with it and tried to bury it in drinks at first, because it was just so, I couldn't get my head around it.
You were heading in a bad direction.
You know, one day I just woke up on the couch, the sun beating on my face and my son crawling on me and trying to wake me up, and I looked up at Tracy, and she was not mad, she was not upset, she was just bored of it, and that was the scariest thing in the world, and I just knew I gotta change this now.
When he met with his neurologist, he was told that he would have 10 years left of acting. By then, at that point, his disease would have worsened and progressed so much that he would have to retire, but until then, he could continue acting. So Michael worked as hard as he could, filming several movies and starred in a new television series, Spin City. On that, he won several awards for things such as Best Actor. However, during mid-season, he released to the public that he did in fact have Parkinson's disease. Many were shocked. Friends and family close to him knew that he had been suffering from a medical condition, but none of them could believe that it was to the extent of Parkinson's. After the release, he soon retired from acting and left Spin City. He then created the Michael J. Fox Foundation. He would spread the word of Parkinson's research and became a face for many victims and sufferers of the disease.
No one knows what triggers Parkinson's, but more than 80,000 Australians have it. Neurons in the brain are damaged and it causes tremors, loss of balance and impaired speech.
Does it feel symmetric when you do that?
No, this is all soft.
For a long time, 7 years, Michael kept it secret. He continued to act, hiding the symptoms for as long as he could. At home, his family was growing, but his condition was worsening. Michael and Tracy have 4 children.
If you're that loved and you're that supported,
You gonna cry?
With the success of the Michael J. Fox Foundation and his newfound optimism, he slowly started to return to acting. At first, he did voice work in movies such as Stuart Little, and slowly gained more confidence as he returned to television series with recurring roles. At this point, Michael continues to raise money for Parkinson's research, as well as plans to return to acting with a sitcom of his own similar to Family Ties and Spin City.
Parkinson's, we all have to work together.
You've got no doubt you're gonna find a cure.
Oh yeah, we're gonna get it done. Because we're looking under every rock and up every tree.
We're in the future. Future, Marty, what do you mean? How can we be in the future?
I don't know how to tell you this, but you're in a time machine.
If you could go back in time, really, you wouldn't change the fact that you got Parkinson's, would you?
No, I wouldn't. I absolutely wouldn't. I mean, there's no, I wouldn't at all. Because this path that I'm on is, I mean, it's, like I said, it's so amazing.
Your Nana told you you were destined for greatness.
Yeah.
Do you think maybe this is what Nana was referring to?
It may have been. Because this certainly, you know, I always say I gave up my job to do my life's work.